Tansay, my name is Angela Hall. I am a teacher, an artist, and I love to share my artwork and how I teach others. As a teacher right now, I'm teaching grade 4, and one of my favorite activities to do is Métis.art, or also known as pointillism. And here are some of the activities that I have been doing. One of my favorite is doing the dot art on a vinyl record. So vinyl records are quite old. In fact, your grandparents probably used them as young children to listen to music. And so we don't often use them anymore, but they make a great art activity. And the reason they make such a wonderful art activity for us as Métis people is because they really show off the beautiful colors. And the Métis people often had their beadwork on black velvet. They were known as the flower beadwork people. They loved to share their learning, especially the Kukums would share their learning with the grandchildren about flower medicine and plant medicine through beading. And so that's why the Métis people are so covered up with beautiful flowers and decorative designs. Another thing you could do is these cool coasters. You can paint them black and then again do Métis dot beadwork on it. You can get wooden shapes and butterflies and flowers. You can use black cardstock paper, or black felt is really a wonderful choice. If it's paint you're not wanting to use, you could use metallic markers. Some of the wonderful resources I have found that really support learning about Métis dot art and the Métis beadwork people are Medicines That Help Us from Gabriel Demart Institute. And this was created by Christy Belcourt, a very famous Métis artist that really shows how powerful it is to create beadwork through art. And in this resource, you get a closer look at her work, as well as in the back, it has many different medicines that you can find throughout Canada, including a map, how you can use the medicine, its name in Cree and in Michif. Leah Dorian is another artist that I just love. I love her work because she uses a lot of rhythmic dots everywhere, and she wants to really highlight that Métis beading. And her work also really supports anything you're learning about flowers and flower medicine. She has this one, Relatives with Roots, and The Giving Tree. I also bring in for my students to see some of my really old moccasins. I got these when I was 13 from my mom. And of course they grew a lot of holes, so I just cut out the top for them to see. And they're still intact. That's how amazing the beadwork is. Many, many years later, not one bead has fallen. And they can really see and highlight the designs. And it really helps with making this artwork. Other things I do to help students learn about the different flowers is I draw them out for them. And I like to recycle things like the vinyl record and cereal boxes. And they make great tracers. And I'll be showing you this today. So let's get ready for an activity.